Hey everybody, it's social media producer Tom Barnes of the WGN Morning News, the Chicago Scene Virtual, and we're here to celebrate something pretty extraordinary, a woman's career that has changed the lives of millions of people, millions upon millions of women, the big exhibit with Ruth Bader Ginsburg at the Illinois Holocaust Museum. And I'm here with Kelly. How are you, Kelly?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. Kelly, real quick, just explain to the folks what you do for the museum and then just dive right into this exhibit, because I feel like this is something, I mean, she has been a huge part of American.
Yes.
Right. And I think maybe because of the pandemic, it's kind of swept under the radar just a tad. So I just want to give people this opportunity to be able to go and view this amazing exhibit at the museum.
Yeah, so I'm vice president of education and exhibitions for the museum. So anything that we do connected to students and teachers, law enforcement, and the public, and all of our special exhibitions at the museum, which includes the Notorious RBG, The Life and Times of Ruth Bader Ginsburg, which is a really incredible multimedia immersive exhibition that takes you through Ruth growing up in Brooklyn, New York, through her time in school, going into law school, meeting her husband, Marty. You get to sit in a car on their first date to kind of watch films from their travel, all the
Wait,
way.
Wait, you say you get to sit in the car on their first date?
Yeah. You
ah,
get to
that's
sit
cool.
in kind of like a little cutout of sure. a 1950s car, as if you're in a like a drive-in movie. Where Marty and Ruth had their first date, and you get to watch some film of their life together. And then it really, the exhibition transitions to some of the key cases, Lilly Ledbetter, Bush versus Gore, some of these key cases that RBG oversaw.
Yeah, I mean, she literally has been part of writing American history, both on her actual career path to get to the Supreme Court, but then when she was in the Supreme Court, things that she did. And that's, I mean, you just said highlights this exhibit. What's your favorite, if you had to pick one of your favorite spots of this exhibit?
Oh, that's so tough. I think,
especially being virtual.
I know. So I think my favorite part of the exhibition that was when it was on site, but also now the virtual tour opportunity, is at the end of the exhibit, and I don't want to give away too much, but you know, Ruth and Marty, her husband, who in his own right was this incredible attorney, had yeah. this amazing, loving relationship. And at the end of the exhibition and the virtual tour, there's a love letter that he writes to her. That's all I'm going to say. It might produce some tears. It's very touching, but it just shows the not only the love, but I think the mutual respect and admiration that they had for each other. So I think that's my favorite.
Yeah, I mean, if people have watched the movie made about her that's been
yes.
out recently, I mean, you realize the love affair that they had for each other and how much he supported her as she trailblazed her way through the court system all the way to the Supreme Court. And not just that, but just standing up for what she believed in to be right. And I think that is something to be celebrated and at an appropriate place at the museum. This runs through the 20th, right?
Right. So we have virtual tours available of the exhibition. There's only 3 dates left. So they're on Wednesday. So February 10th, 17th, and 20th. And you can sign up through our website at ilholocaustmuseum.org.
And if people want to follow you guys on social medias outside of the website, what's the best way for people to do that?
So any of our social media channels, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, at IHMEC.
And do you have any little previews for any events that are coming up in the next couple months?
So we're getting ready actually now that Notorious RBG is down. We're actually currently installing our next big special exhibition on Nelson Mandela and the struggle for freedom, which tells the story of the fight against apartheid in South Africa. Mandela is obviously the key central figure towards that work, but really the larger community and world and citizens that were activists to fight against the oppression that they faced at the time.
And that's coming up a little bit later in the spring?
We are opening it actually Thursday, February 18th, and it's going to run through September. So right around the corner. And
right.
you can visit on site where we opened actually yesterday. And we also have a virtual tour opportunity.
I
so
think
exciting.
That's something to be celebrated
yes.
these days,
so
right?
So exciting, yes. Yep,
yeah. So people buy tickets on the website ahead of time to make sure
yes,
that
you can buy your tickets online. And, you know, we have all the, you know, safety protocols, exhibits are being wiped down, masks are required, but we're making it as safe as possible as we can during this time.
Kelly, thank you so much for joining me today. I appreciate it. And just talking to you on a lovely, sunny, frigid day, though, gives me hope for the spring with everything that's been going on in the world. So thank you for sharing time with me today. I appreciate
it. Thank you. Anytime I could talk about RBG, happy to.